वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज ऑन मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला. सो इन मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला, सो दिस इज द पार्ट टू. सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव सीन व्हाट इज सिग्नल फ्लो ग्राफ, व्हाट इज मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला, एंड वी हैव स्टडीड इन डिटेल अबाउट द मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट द वेरियस वेरिएबल्स एंड द वेरियस पैरामीटर्स इन द मेसन्स गेन फॉर्मूला अलॉन्ग विथ वन एग्जाम्पल. सो टूडे इन दिस video lecture we will be going with the Mason's gain formula, but along with the Mason's gain formula we will see some of the examples related to Mason's gain formula. So before going to the some of the examples of Mason's gain formula, let us see the comparison between the block diagram and signal flow graph. So here we have a comparison chart between block diagram and signal flow graph, and why this comparison need to be studied, because it shows you the relationship between, or it shows how the signal flow graph is varying with respect to the block diagram. Okay, so in block diagram you can see here the first point shows the basic importance is given to the elements and their transfer function, because in block diagram we have seen many blocks, okay, in terms of G block and in terms of H block. So those blocks are given more important because all the rules are applied to the block diagram itself. But in case of signal flow graph, the basic importance is given to the variables of the system. Variables in the sense your input, output, nodes, branch, these are the variables, and the more importance will be given to the variables rather than the block diagram. And in block diagram each element is represented by a block, and in signal flow graph each variable is represented by a separate node. It means instead of the blocks of G and block of H, we represent it by a separate node in signal flow graph. That is the main difference here. Then the third point says the transfer function of the element shown inside the corresponding block. So whatever block we see in the signal block diagram, so those block diagram block consists of the transfer function. It can be G1, G2, G3, H1, H2. It can be anything. Okay. So but here in case of signal flow graph, the block diagram or the transfer function is shown along the branches connecting the nodes. For example, if the two nodes are connecting, the branch to then that particular line is nothing but branch, and that branch can may have some number, either it can be 1, it can be H2, it can be G1, it can be some number or some numerical number. So what we have seen in the previous lecture. The fourth point here in the block diagram is the summing points and the takeoff points are separate. We have summing points and we have some takeoff points, what we have seen in the block diagram. But here in the signal flow graphs, we don't have any summing points and takeoff points. Instead of summing points and takeoff points, they are just represented by a normal node. Okay, and that node may consist of some incoming branch or may consist of some outgoing branch, or it consists of both, either incoming branch or it can be outgoing branch. This is the difference. So the fifth difference here is the feedback path is present from output to input. That is what in the block diagram, if you have a feedback, the feedback is taken from always from takeoff point moving towards the summing point. But in case of a signal flow graph, instead of a feedback path, we have some loop mechanism. Okay, so here some kind of looping structures are drawn with respect to the signal flow graph, and those loops represent feedback in signal flow graph. The sixth point here is the minor feedback loop present is given by the formula G of S divided by 1 plus 1 plus or minus G of S into H of S. That is the transfer function. But here we don't have such formula. Okay, and it is not even necessary to use this gain formula. Simply we go for finding the overall transfer function. Overall in the sense, for a given signal flow graph, you need to find the overall transfer function. But in case of the block diagram, you need to find this transfer function for the minor loop, and you have to reduce that and then go for solving the complete block diagram. So that is what it is a bit difficult in block diagram as compared to signal flow graph. Similarly, we have some block diagram reduction rules used to obtain the resultant function. We have seen the various block diagram reduction rules like blocks in series, blocks in parallel, right? A feedback. So there are many block diagram reduction rules were there. But here, In signal flow graphs, we don't have any block diagram reduction rules or signal flow graph reduction rules. Rather, we have the Mazin's gain formula. This Mazin's gain formula is available, which can directly use to get the overall transfer function for the signal flow graph. And here you need not to go for reducing the signal flow graph. Only one diagram and the whole calculation we have. Then the eighth point here, we have the methodology is slightly complicated and it is also time consuming because you need to reduce the block diagram and then you need to construct the modified block diagram. But in case of signal flow graph, we need not to redraw the signal flow graph again and again and again. Once drawn, then simply use the Mazin's gain formula to find the overall transfer function for the given signal flow graph. That is the major difference here we have. The time is a bit reduced. The ninth point says the concept of self loop is not existing in the block diagram. We don't have any concept of self loop in a block diagram, but the self loop exists in signal flow graph. What we have seen in yesterday's problem, a node itself has a loop, but here a block cannot have a loop. A block cannot have a feedback in its own forward path, or sometimes it can be in the backward direction. So therefore, here the self looping does not exist in block diagram. The last point is it is applicable only to the linear time invariant system. And in case of the signal flow graph, it is applicable to linear time invariant system. So both are almost similar. So this is what the overall differences between signal flow graph and block diagram. Now, in signal flow graph and block diagram, here we have some applications related to signal flow graph, okay, which is nothing but your overall gain, or simply you can call the general gain formula between output node and the input nodes. Okay, so here they have taken one example and they have applied the Mazin's gain formula just to calculate the overall transfer function. Okay, so whatever we have seen in the yesterday's class, same thing can be applied to solve this given signal flow graph. Okay, similarly, we may have some few more examples here. You can see, just calculate Y7 divided by Y2. Okay, the question may be a bit different always. It need not to be always similar. Okay, so question may come in like calculate the transfer function using Mazin's gain formula, or they will ask calculate Y1 divided by Y2. Is it Y2 or Y7 divided by Y2 of the system or signal flow graph is shown in the figure below. So you need to go for applying simply the Mazin's gain formula and try to find the overall transfer function. Okay, so today let us solve this problem and see how this Mazin's gain formula can be applied to the given signal flow graph. So let us consider this problem example, that is 6.2. So here the signal flow graph is given. So in the signal flow graph, already they have shown or they have labeled the various variables and the parameters. Okay, so let us make it more clear by considering this given signal flow graph, where you can see in the given question they have asked calculate Y7 divided by Y2. It is Y7 divided by Y2. They have not mentioned Y1. Okay, they have not mentioned Y1. The reason because is here your Y2 is the input node and Y7 is the output node. But we cannot start our problem directly from this particular node. So therefore, it is necessary to install or to add one dummy node whose gain should be equal to 1 always. Okay, a dummy node whose gain should be equal to 1 always, and it has some input represented by some any variable. If you take the same variable name, then it will be much better for you to solve the given problem. So therefore, in the figure, instead of Y2 as an input node, now it is changed to Y1. So therefore, you need to find the transfer function, that is output, that is represented by Y7 divided by Y1, which acts as an input. Okay, so this is the transfer function representation. It is given by TF is equal to transfer function is equal to Y7 divided by Y1. This is the given problem. Now, so the very step first step we apply to solve this problem here is always go for finding the forward path. Always go for finding the forward path. Forward path, you should know the definition of forward path before applying it to the signal flow graph. So what is forward path here is, basically the forward path is, it should start from the input and it should end at the output. It should start at input and it should start at output, and you need to calculate the total or the overall gain of that particular forward path. And based on the number of forward path, okay, you need to find the value of K is how much. Okay, based on what? Based on the number of forward path, you will get the value of K. And why it is necessary to find the value of K? Because in Mason's gain formula, we have delta K and also TK, and that K represents my total number of forward path. Okay, so therefore it is necessary to find the value of K. Similarly, go for finding the forward path. So let us find the forward path. Okay, and the forward path will be denoted by or represented by the letter T. Okay, denoted by letter T. So now let us go for finding the forward path. It should start from the input and it should end at particular output. So if you look at this, let us start from Y1. So that is Y1, it goes to Y2, then Y3, Y4, Y5, Y6 and Y7. So this is my one forward path. Okay, so this is my one forward path, and it is represented by the letter T1. You can see here T1. And what you should do, once you trace the forward path, you should multiply their gain. So therefore, T1 is nothing but my first forward path, whose gain is nothing but the multiplication of all the branch gain. So therefore, let us denote it by T1 is my first forward path, whose gain are 1 multiplied by G1, multiplied by G2, multiplied by G3, multiplied by G4, multiplied by 1. So simply, it is just like your G1, okay, G2, comma G3, comma G4. Okay, so this is your first forward path gain. Okay, now similarly, try to observe very carefully. If you have the forward path something a bit different compared to the first forward path, so go for tracing. How to trace is the very simple logic here. What you can apply is, do not consider the backward path or backward arrow mark. So therefore, I cannot consider this minus H1, minus H2 and minus H3. Not even this part, that is minus H4, because this is a loop. This is a loop. So therefore, we cannot consider this as a forward path. So therefore, here there is one arrow which is going from Y4 till Y6. Okay. So this can be my another forward path. So how to start? Again, you need to start it from the first, not from Y4. Okay, start from Y1. Okay, so let us represent here by Y1. So that is the second forward path, representing it by T2 is equal to, start from Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4. From Y4, don't go to Y5, because it is already, we have taken this forward path. So start from after Y4, go towards G5. And end at Y6 and then Y7. So the gain for those particular branch is, it is 1, okay, then G1, then it is G2. Okay, you cannot take G3 because we have not taken this path. So once you go to the G2, from Y4, go towards G5. So it is G5, then come to point number 6 and then towards the Y7, as it is 1. So 1 multiplied by the same number itself is the 1. So here in the problem, you can see the first forward path is given by these values and second forward path is given by these values. If you want to make it more clear, for the forward path, simply you can write it as like this, that is T1 is equal to, so it starts from Y1, right? So Y1, okay, then Y2, then Y3, it is not minus, okay, it shows the flow of signal, Y3, then Y4, then Y5, then Y6 and Y7. Then Y7. So this is my first forward path. For that particular forward path, simply you can write the gain of that particular branch. Gain in the sense Y1 and Y2. So simply you can write it as 1 multiplied by G1 multiplied by G2 multiplied by G3 multiplied by G4 multiplied by simple 1. Okay, so both are correct. So you can go with this particular format. Both are correct. Either you can write it directly or you can go for writing the all, tracing all the values, okay, and then write the their gain and then go for tracing the second forward path and write their gain. You will get the same answers. Okay. Now, so once you obtain the number of total forward path, how many we have? That is T1 and T2. So what should be the value of K now? So the value of K here will be equal to 2. Okay. So the value of K is equal to 2. Okay. So we have obtained the value of K now. After finding the value of K, after finding the value of these two forward paths, you should go for finding the loop. Okay. So the loop here are, it starts from Y1. Check loop in the sense, you need to define the loop. It should start from one point. Okay. And it should end on the same point. Okay. So therefore, how many loops we have? We can check. This is my first loop. Okay. This is my first loop. Okay. So this is second loop. Okay. This is third loop. You can see third loop. A bigger loop is a third loop. And I have one self loop that is represented by 4. Okay. This is my self loop. So L1, L2, L3 and L4. Okay. And how to write the equations for all the loops? Okay, so to write the equations for this particular loop, we start with first loop. Okay, start from Y2, Y3. Okay, and then come back to Y2. So you, what you should do, you should simply multiply this G1 multiplied by H1. Okay, so G1 multiplied by H1. You can see here in the figure. So the first loop, they have drawn it separately to make it more clear. So first loop is G1 multiplied by H1. So simply you add the branch gain to obtain L1. You can see L1 is equal to mine along with the sign. Okay. So minus G1 multiplied by H1. Okay. So this is my second loop. Start from Y4, Y5, back to Y4. So the gain associated with this loop is G3 multiplied by minus H2. So therefore, L2 is equal to minus G3 multiplied by H2. So this is my second loop. Now the third loop here is, it's a bigger loop, which starts from Y2, Y3, Y4,